Hello everyone, it's Actec once again. I think it's about 4 days ago I posted a video on this channel. We're going to continue with where we ended last time. Okay, so I welcome everybody once again to my channel, and then I appreciate what you have been doing. I think I'm getting some like and sharing. Thank you very much. I also urge, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please do well and subscribe. And if you have already subscribed to, please do well and like my videos and share. Thank you very much. All right, so today what we are going to do is we're going to deal with the edit button. Okay, so let's open the student form. Yeah, so last time what we did was looking at the delete button. So let's deal with the edit button quick and fast. I think I've already added some code to it already, so let me see. Design view, let's click on this, and events. Okay, so this is the code I think I've already written here, and this is going to be a short video. So if the count action, this is what it is. Say if the count actions from the student table action is yes, is equal to zero, then you throw a message, no record selected. Else the count action is action yes is greater than one, then it also threw a message saying that select only one record for editing. Yeah, so with the editing you can only select one record, you can't do with multiple records. So when you select the, if no record is selected, then it will throw a message, no record selected. If you select multiple records, it will also tell you that you have selected multiple record, and so only one record could be edited. So we come else. Now if only one record is selected, then it will throw this thing. It will open the student form, which is add student, and then the action is yes, and then in edit mode. So a very simple code and a short code here. All right, so let's try that. So let's see, no record selected, fine. Select multiple, select only one record for editing, then select one. Okay, so it opens the record that we selected in edit mode. So let me see, let's edit again and try to change, add one more name to this, Sam. All right, and then let's see if yeah, so you can see that there's Sam has, we have added another name to it. You can see that there has been a change in the name. There's been a change in the name. So that is the edit button working here. So we're looking at Samuel. All right, so let me change Samuel to junior high and see. Okay, Samuel, let's edit once again. I think this did not work. Okay, it is showing junior high here, but on the form it is lower primary. All right, so we are done with the delete button, but there is something I want to do in addition to what we did under the delete button. Now for us to delete records straight away when we click on this, I want the system to throw a message telling us that we are going to delete some record, and if you want to continue, then then we prevent or continue with our deletes. Okay, so let me do that quickly. Close this. Let's go to here. Okay, so we're going to declare some variable. I will say dim. I say dim response as string. All right. Then we say response equal msg box. We have ms box. Are you sure you want to delete selected records? Making it a little fancy here. All right. So it's a question. And I say VB yes no plus VB question. VB question. Then title we say confirm deletion. That is the title of our course. Okay, let me close that. Okay, so that is it. So if response for if response equal VB yes, then okay. So if response equal VB yes, then if action continue like that, so you see. Else, else, let me copy this MSG box, this information we have here. Okay, I'm going to put it. All right, then we put it here. Okay, delete cancel. Delete cancel. Delete cancel. Am I correct here? Okay, delete cancel. All right, so that is it. I think let me check my if respond equal VBS, then if the count the message was no record selected, else. Else. All right, let's try this one, see. Oh, sorry, let's delete. Okay, so else without. Okay, so we get end if. Guess another end if. Okay, let me put end if here. Let's end if for this, and then let me take this one out. Let's save and try again. Save. Let me try again and see what's happening. Okay, so all right. Are you sure you want to delete selected record? Yes, so record deleted. Okay, so that is, let's try again. Nalemu Carol. Let me delete and say yes. Okay, so record deleted. You select another one, this, and then cancel. Okay, so I think this is a nice way of programming your access database. I think I am going to end here with the video. We shall continue next time. Please, if you have not subscribed, do well and subscribe for me. If you've already subscribed, thank you very much. Continue watching my videos and you're going to learn a lot from me. Thank you. I'll see you in the next video.